Yeah.
All right. So for today, we want to discuss on questions for two population means for case independent and dependent sample. Okay. So for independent sample. Okay. For December 2019. Okay. So in this question, okay, the data given for 80 patients or at Tawakal Health Center, and then the study wants to determine whether there is a significant difference in the BMI between male and female. So we have two population, which is male and female. Okay, kita ada dua lah. And then this is the partial output. Okay, the equation only give you the value for the statistic. Okay, so maksudnya the equation dia tak bagi dekat you this data. Okay, only partial, half sahaja dia bagi this one only. Okay, so we know that this is the value for sample for male. So this is for male, this is for female, and this is the mean for male, mean for female, standard deviation for male, female, and standard error mean for male and female. Okay, so once we know that group statistics, so we know that all this value is for sample. Okay, so standard deviation for sample, mean for sample. Okay, sample, this is the sample size and standard error mean. So for A, show the standard error difference is 0.9425. Okay, so we know that for case two population means. Okay, so for each formula ni kita kena tahu this is our point estimate or mean difference. Okay, and then after plus minus, this is our margin of error. So if the question asks you to calculate the margin of error, so you must include the statistical table. But if the question only asks you to find the standard error difference, so only this one. Okay, so this is the value for standard error difference. Okay, same goes to case variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. So kalau disuruh kira margin of error, so termasuk this one, statistical table. But if the question asks you to calculate the standard error difference, so only this one lah. Okay, dalam case yang ini, for case N less than 30, so this is your margin of error and then this is your standard error difference. Okay, after yang you punya statistical table tu, this is your standard error difference. Okay, so sama juga in this case, this is your standard error difference. Okay, so for this case, since this is the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown, so bila unknown, kita ada dua case, either large or small sample. But in this case, since both population ni adalah more than and equal to 30. Okay, so we know that the case is, okay, the case is n more than and equal to 30 large. So to calculate, okay, the standard error difference ni kita akan guna this formula. Okay, so in this case, so you akan use this formula, okay, standard error difference. So just substitute the value. So we have the value for standard deviation for male and female. So just substitute this value into the equation and then you will get 0.9425 since the equation asks you to show this value. Okay, so ada four decimal places. So you follow lah four decimal places. Okay, so this is for question A. And then for question B, okay, the question B, the question asks you to calculate the margin of error for the BMI between male and female. So kita tahu for margin of error, they include this value, okay, statistical table. So you just tambah this one je lah and then times with you punya standard error difference. Okay, so this one nanti you baca table is equal to 0.025. Okay, so nanti bila you baca table, you akan dapat 1.96. And then yang ini you boleh buat macam ni ataupun since in A you dah kira, so yang ini you boleh masukkan je terus. Okay, boleh juga. Okay, so, but nanti you akan dapat the answer is 1.8473. Okay, so this will be your answer for margin of error. Okay, so itu adalah for B. And then for C, the question asks you to construct the 95% confidence interval for the mean difference in BMI between male and female. Okay, so since kita dah kira the value for margin of error, so you just tolakkan this one je lah. Okay, you punya point estimate or you punya mean difference. Okay, so our mean difference is this one. Okay, so 27 point ni so you akan dapat 3.02. And then this one, you boleh tulis balik or you can take the value from B. Okay, ataupun you terus je tulis this value. Okay, since yang ini you dah dapat from B. Okay, so nanti you akan dapat your lower limit is 1.1727 and your upper limit is 4.8673. Okay, so this is the value for lower and upper limit. And the question asks you to explain. Okay, so how to explain this interpret macam biasa. We are 95% confident that the mean difference in BMI between men and female is between this one and this one. Okay, since in the equation dia tak ada mention about the unit, so you just buat macam ni sajalah. Okay, so that is for December 2019. Any question for this question? Boleh?
Boleh.
Boleh. Alright, so kalau tak ada any question, we go to June 2018. Okay, so for June 2018, so dekat sini dia bagi the SPSS output for both group statistic and independent sample test. So we know that this is the value for your sample size, and then this is your mean. Okay, this is your standard deviation, and this is your standard error mean. And then for independent sample test, so ini adalah if the question asks you to test for equality of variances, and then for test for equality of means, kita only look at this mean difference, which is this is x bar 1 minus x bar 2, and then standard error difference follow the case either equal or unequal variance. Okay, so you tengok lah. So yang ni dia punya output ni dia macam lain sikit. Selalunya kita tengok output yang macam this one. Okay, so now kita ada juga okay output yang macam dia dalam bentuk apa namanya tu horizontal macam ni. Okay, yang this one dia dalam bentuk vertical. Okay, nilai tu dia menegak. Okay, tapi dia benda yang sama je lah cara nak baca dia. Okay, so this is your lower and upper limit. So bila nak baca for equal, this is your lower and then this is your upper. Okay, so in this questions, okay, for A, the question asks you based on p-value in living test, test the equality of variances in this study, use alpha 0.05. Okay, so dia suruh you test for living test. So macam biasa, kena ada the four steps. Okay, so this is your hypothesis, alright, and then your p-value. So how to read the p-value, we will take from this one. Okay, this is your value for p-value. Okay, so you mesti baca dekat living test for equality of variances. Okay, so 0.28, and then dia suruh test using 0.05. Okay, so this is your alpha. And then this is our decision rule, reject Heschnell if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. And then we compare for this value, okay, p-value and alpha. So since p-value is more than alpha, so we fail to reject Heschnell. Okay, so once we fail to reject Heschnell, so kita mengatakan dia adalah equal variance. So this is your conclusion. Okay, so this is how to answer the questions for equality of variances. Okay, so kalau living test je, you mesti buat all this step. Okay, so that is for living test. So we know that now the case is equal variance. So kita nak tengok on this one only. Okay, so yang ni kita nak tengok lah. Okay, so for B, calculate the standard error difference for the mean difference in the length of drive in kilometer between single driver and married driver. So this row you calculate the standard error difference untuk this case. So okay, so kita akan guna this one lah. Okay, so kenapa kita guna this one? Since kita tahu this is the case for both sample is large, so kita akan guna this one, okay, this formula. Okay, so so nanti you akan guna this formula and then you just substitute the value. So nanti you akan dapat 7.04585. Okay, so that is for B. Okay, you akan guna yang this one ya, yang large. Okay, and then for C question asks you to construct 95% confidence interval for the mean difference in length of drive in kilometer between single and married driver. Okay, so we know that the case is equal variance. So kita akan guna apa nama itu? Oh, sorry. Ini tak ada kaitan pun. Okay, since the case is a large sample, so automatically kita akan guna this one lah. Okay, kita akan guna this formula, Z distribution. Okay, so just masukkan sahaja dalam apa nama itu, dalam formula. Okay, so nanti you akan dapat this one, you baca table, you akan dapat 1.96. Okay, and then this one 7.357. And then your lower limit, negative 6.4528 and 21.1668. Okay, so this will be the answer for C. Okay, so actually for question for apa nama itu, case large sample ni, kalau you tengok for previous example, they actually supposedly you tak perlu ada this partial apa nama itu, only this one je since the case is large. Okay, so yang ni independent sample test ni usually kita guna untuk bila case tu adalah case apa nama itu, small sample. Okay, salah satu ni kecil. Sebab tu kita test sebab kita nak tahu which formula yang kita nak guna. Okay, but since in this case for both population ni memang large, so you just ignore je lah untuk yang A ni sama ada equal ke unequal. Okay, so itu adalah untuk question June 2018. Okay, so any question for June 2018 sama dapat dengan kawan you? Boleh tak?
Boleh, sama.
Boleh, alright. So untuk next question January 2018. Okay, so yang ni sama juga, dia bagi dekat you group statistic. So you ada N for public and private. So N1, N2, X bar 1, X bar 2, S1, S2, S1 over square of N, S2 over square of N2. Okay, so dalam kes ni dia kata based on the living test, what can be concluded about the equality of variances. Okay, so ni macam biasa je, kita tengok this value, you punya p-value. So dekat sini, so this is your hypothesis, this is your p-value, and then rejectional if p-value less than or equal to alpha. So since nilai ni more than, so we fail to reject, so you akan dapat equal variance. Okay, so itulah untuk A. And then for B, calculate the margin of error for the mean difference in starting monthly salary between graduate of public and private. So since this case is a large sample, so you akan guna Z lah. Okay, you akan guna this one lah. Okay, this value. So the question asks you to find the margin of error. Okay, good. Kita akan guna this one. Okay, so you just substitute into the formula. So you akan dapat nanti 23.2852. Okay, this should be your answer for margin of error. Alright, and then the last one. For C, construct 95% confidence interval for the mean difference. So kita akan guna Z. Since in B, you already calculate the value for margin of error, so just substitute this value. Okay, so nanti you akan dapat 52.9148 and upper limit is 99.4852. Okay, this should be your answer. And the question asks you to explain, so we are 95% confident that the mean difference in the starting monthly salary is between. So dekat situ, okay, so it's between this one lah. So this is the answer for January 2018. So buat macam biasa saja. Okay, why we use Z? Since in the output, given the value is for large sample, okay, both population the N is more than and equal to 30. Okay, that's why kita guna this formula. Okay, so that is for January 2018, and the last one for July 2017. So in this case, this is the data for enrollment for research and primary care. So we have research and primary care. So now dia punya sample size dia for both population ni small lah. So kita tahu this is the case for small sample. Okay, S1, S2, S1 over square of N. square of n. And then the question asks you to, based on the p-value in living test, test the equality of variances in the study. So kita akan tengok on this one. Okay, the p-value is 0.747. So this one. Alright, so make sure bila you write your hypothesis, jangan tertinggal, apa, jangan terlupa you punya 1 and 2. Okay, variance pertama and variance kedua. Okay, so kalau you buat macam kawan you ni, so salah lah, since symbol dia tak betul. Okay, so don't forget to write this one. Okay, dia bukan macam ni. Okay, dia ada satu. Okay, so make sure you buat betul lah. Okay, so this is your hypothesis, and then p-value is 0.747, and then decision rule rejection if p-value is less than or equal to alpha. So we compare for both value, okay, p-value and alpha, since the value is more than, so kita fail to reject, so the conclusion will be equal variance lah. Okay, so since kita tahu dia adalah equal variance, so kita akan tengok on this one je lah. Okay, value tu kita akan tengok yang ini sahaja. So for B, this will construct the 90% confidence interval for the mean enrollment in research. So kita tahu in these questions, we have enrollment for research and primary care. But for question B, the question only asks you to construct the 90% confidence interval for research only. So that means this is the case for one population mean. Okay, so bila case one population mean, so kita akan tengok dekat research sahaja. So we know that this is the case for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. So bila unknown, kita ada two case, either large sample or small sample. But in this case, since n is only 17, so less than 30, so kita akan guna this one lah, this formula. Okay, since the question only asks you about one population. Okay, so you akan guna this formula. Okay, and then just substitute. So kat sini nanti T 0.0516. Okay, since dekat sini you punya N is 17, so nanti you akan dapat this value lah, 1.746. Okay, and then you punya lower limit, you akan dapat 525.6019, and your upper limit 663.3392. Okay, so this will be your answer. Okay, so make sure you tengok betul-betul soalan tu. Okay, so dia nak tanya for research sahaja, so only for one population. If the question asks you to construct the 90% confidence interval for the mean enrollment in research and primary care, so yang itu baru kita guna two population mean. Okay, and then for C, based on the confidence interval in B, is the mean enrollment in research is differ. So macam biasa, we look at number zero. Okay, either zero is in the confidence interval or not. So in this case, since zero is not in the confidence interval, so kita kata no. Okay, no. No ke ya? Is differ. So kat sini kita kata yes lah. Kita boleh kata dia differ. Okay, so kita kata yes. Okay, we can. Okay, yes, we can conclude that the mean enrollment in research is differ since, ni you tak payah buat mean yang ni lah. You just tengok nilai zero tu saja. So kita kata since zero is not in the confidence interval. Okay, so you tengok based on nilai zero je lah. Okay, so kalau macam dia kata, kalau contohnya soalan ni kata sama ada differ from 250 contohnya. Yang tu barulah you tengok 250 tu ada dalam this interval ke tak macam tu. Okay, so kalau ada nilai, dia bagi nilai, baru you tengok nilai. If the question do not give you any value, so you just refer to value zero. Zero ada ke tak dalam confidence interval. Okay, and then for this, state the 95% confidence interval for the mean difference in enrollment of those specializing in research and primary care. So soalan ask you to state, okay, state the 95% confidence interval. So since in A, we already test for living test and we conclude that the case is equal variance. Okay, so kita akan tengok only this one, okay, equal variance. So when the question asks you to state the 95% confidence interval. So kita akan take this value lah. Okay, so just write the value. Okay, so sini, so nanti akan jadi negative 8.4692, and then your upper limit is 234.41100. Okay, so make sure if the question give you in 5 decimal places, you follow sahaja. Okay, so kalau you buat negative 8.4698 234.4110, so wrong lah. Okay, bila dia kata state, you mesti follow. Okay, how many decimal places in the output. Okay, so itu adalah 4D. And the last one, find X. So X is the standard error difference for unequal. So for unequal, so this one lah. Okay, dia suruh you calculate this value. So just substitute sahaja. So masukkan sahaja, so nanti you akan dapat 59.72627. Okay, so this is the value for X. Okay, so any question for independent sample test? Boleh? For independent sample?
Boleh.
Alright. Okay, so next kita nak tengok on dependent. Okay, so for dependent sample for June 2019. So kat sini dia bagi dekat you untuk one indicator physical fitness, resting pulse rate. So kita ada 10 men volunteer to test the exercise. And then dia kata measure before and after 6 weeks. Okay, and then kat sini dah bagi data dah before and after. So kita tahu dekat dalam kes yang ini, this is your D. Then this is your D bar. Okay, this is your SD. And then this is your confidence interval, lower and upper limit. Okay, so this is N minus 1. So yang ni kita akan tengok dekat topik 4 lah, test statistik ni. So for A, find the value of G. So kita tahu G is the value for D bar, mean. Okay, so macam I kata, if the question already give you the value for before and after, okay, to get the value for G, you can just minus this value. Okay, since dia dah bagi before minus after, so you tolak before minus after. Kalau kat sini dia tulis after minus before, so you buat after minus before. Follow the questions. Okay, follow the output. So for G, just minus the value, so nanti you akan dapat, okay, 3.2. Okay, so that is the value for your D, G, okay, your D bar. And then for, okay, and then for B, state the 95% confidence interval. So macam biasa, state just tulis sahaja the value. So follow how many decimal places. So 1.66203 and your upper limit 4.73797. So if you want to write this answer in decimal, in interval, so make sure you buat betul lah. Sini mesti mu D. Okay. So sama juga untuk this case. Okay, so kalau you nak buat in decimal places, so make sure 6982, sini mu 1 minus mu 2. Alright, so itu adalah untuk answer for B. And for C, dia suruh show the 95% confidence interval for the mean difference before and after 6 weeks. So dia suruh show how to get this value. Okay, so just substitute, okay, D bar and then D alpha over 2 N minus 1, so SD over square of N. Okay, so since in this output, they only give you the value for standard deviation. Kalau dekat sini ada standard error mean, baru you boleh terus masukkan nilai yang diberi. Since dekat dalam questions ni tak ada, so you kena masukkanlah your value for SD and your square of N. Okay, so this is the formula and then P 0.0259, so 2.26. And then since the question asks you to show, so make sure you follow the output. Okay. 797. Okay. So yang ni je lah. You follow this output. Dia ada apa nama itu? 5 decimal places ni, 5 decimal places. So kat sini pun you follow 5 decimal places. Okay. Kalau dia dekat questions ni dia kata find or calculate, baru you buat 4 decimal places. But the question asks you to show, so kena follow lah dia punya decimal places. Alright, so that is for question June 2019. Any questions for June 2019 boleh?
Boleh.
Alright. So kalau tak ada, kita tengok on December 2018. Okay, so kat sini dah bagi dekat you only PET sample test. Okay, dia tak ada bagi data yang macam ni. Okay, dia tak ada bagi dekat you. Dia only bagi the PET sample test. So this is your D-bar, this is your SD, SD over square root of N, and this is your lower and upper limit. And then this is your degree of freedom, okay, and minus one. So for A, show the degree of freedom is the same as the output. So you just show sahajalah your N since dekat sini. And dia bagi tau. And dia tak bagi eh. Okay, dia bagi. Dia di company. Sekejap. Okay, so N minus 1. So N is equal to 5. Okay, so ada ke tak ada? Macam tak ada ke? The measure should higher to improve the girls to improve the... Okay, so kalau macam tak ada, you boleh tahulah nak dapatkan the value for N tu. Kita tahu df is equal to 4. So N minus 1 is equal to 4, N is equal to 5. Okay, in case you tak tahu macam nak dapatkan this value. Okay, so dia suruh show degree of freedom. So N minus 1, 5 minus 1, so it's equal to 4. Okay, so that is for A. And then for B, state the 95% confidence interval. So just ambil this value lah. Okay. So negative 9.784 and negative 0.096. Okay. So that is the value. And then make sure nanti after this kalau buat quiz ke test ke, make sure kalau yang titik tu you tebalkan sikit titik eh. Takut nanti I tak perasan. Okay. Tak perasan the dot tu. Okay. So that is for B. And then for C, based on the confidence interval, is the cell had improved. Okay, so sama in this question we look at on our confidence interval. Okay, so kita tengok dekat sini 0 is not in the confidence interval. So we know that the cell had improved. Okay, yes. Okay, the cell had improved because 0 is outside the confidence interval. Okay, or not in the confidence interval. Boleh. Okay, so that is for C. Okay, so any questions for December 2018? Boleh?
Boleh.
So kalau tak ada any question, you go to January 2018. Okay, so in this case, dia bagi for memory before and after. And then kita ada PET sample, so sama, this is your D-bar. Your SD, SD over square root of N, your lower and upper limit. Okay, so this is your degree of freedom. So the question asks you to find the value for D and E. Okay, so nak cari D since the output already give you the sample statistic for mean for both, apa nama itu, before and after. So you just minus je lah. Okay, since dekat sini dia memang buat memory 1 minus memory 2, dia punya D. So kita 2.15 minus 4.95. Okay, so nanti akan dapat negative 2.8. Okay, so this is the value for D. And then for E, E is your degree of freedom. So we know that the N is 20. So 20 minus 1 is equal to 19. Okay, so this is the answer for A. And then for B, state the 95% confidence interval and explain. So this is your lower and upper limit. So just follow the output. Okay, negative 3.360 and negative 2.240. Okay, so this is your confidence interval. And then the question asks you to interpret. So we are 95% confident that the mean difference of memory capability of a group of autistic children before and after is between this one. Okay, boleh. Okay, so that is the answer for B. Okay, so rasa tak ada masalah for January. And the last one for July 2017. Okay, so yang ni actually questions ni sama macam example dalam our slide. Okay, so for M, dia suruh find the mean for M. So sama in this case, either you want to find the D dulu, okay, without tolak with. Okay, you cari dulu the value for D ni. Okay, and then you masukkan dalam your calculator and then find your M. Or you can find the mean for without and then mean for with and then you minuskan these two value. Okay, you can use any method. Tak ada masalah. Okay, both is correct. Okay, so in this case, so kawan you guna apa nama itu, just minuskan the value. Dia cari the value for D-bar. So nanti you akan dapat negative 10.3 over 6. So you akan dapat negative 1.717. So macam I mentioned before, so yang ini you tak perlu show pun tak apa. You just apa nama itu, tulis dekat you punya soalan saja, tak ada masalah. Okay, make sure you just show this value je lah. Okay, so that is for A. And then for B, state the 95% confidence interval for the mean difference. Okay, so dia suruh state sahaja. So this is the value. Okay, for 95% confidence interval, just salin and then show the standard error mean is the same as the output. So standard error mean is this one. This is the formula. And then we know that this is the value for SD. And then the N is 6. Okay, you substitute and then you akan dapat this one lah. Okay, since the question ask you to show. So make sure you follow the output. Yang ni pun sama, tertinggal 6. Okay. So that is how to answer this question. Okay, for dependent. Okay, so any questions before we end our class? Boleh. And then lagi satu, in case lagi satu, tu dalam soalan tu kan, misal kata the questions dekat sini, contohnya dia kata mana soalan ada show. So contohnya soalan tu suruh you calculate. Misal katalah soalan tu suruh you calculate kan. Contohnya dia kata calculate ataupun find the 90 ataupun dia kata find the confidence interval for the mean difference before and after 6 weeks. Contohnya dia tak bagi tahu berapa persen. So if the question do not mention about the confidence level, confidence interval dia berapa, so you tengok dekat output. Okay, in case soalan tu dia tak bagi. Okay, so nak tengok dekat mana, you tengok dekat output. Okay, and then lagi satu, kalau contohnya the question ask you to apa nama itu, calculate or find 90% confidence interval, for example. So this value, you punya lower and upper limit, dia takkan sama dengan this output. Why? Since output ni adalah 95% confidence interval. Okay, but dia suruh you kira 98% confidence interval. So value ni dia tak akan sama. Okay, so nanti you tak payahlah pelik kenapa jawapan lower and upper limit you berbeza. Okay, berbeza kerana this answer is for 95% confidence interval. Okay, but the question ask you to find the 98% confidence interval. So you punya lower and upper limit will be difference lah, berbeza lah. Okay, dengan the output. Okay, yang tu you kena hati-hatilah. Okay, kalau output tu memang bagi 95% confidence interval and then dia suruh you calculate 95% confidence interval, so barulah you punya lower and upper limit akan sama with the output. Okay, so itu sahaja. So we already finish discuss on topic 3. So kita dah habis cover for 1 and 2 population means. Okay, so after raya we will look at on new topic, which is hypothesis testing. Okay, so for hypothesis testing, the case sama. Okay, so kita akan tengok juga on the formula tu, kita ada variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. And then kita tengok case tu, kalau small guna formula lain, large guna formula lain. Cuma yang berbeza dia adalah the step tu, dia akan sama macam how to solve your living test. okay, kita akan ada step hypothesis testing, you punya test statistic or p-value or confidence interval, and then apa nama itu, you punya decision rule, decision, and then you punya conclusion. So kita akan ada, kita akan ada step dia lah to answer that equation. Tapi tak apa, tu kita akan look at after raya, okay, after raya Aidilfitri. So any questions before we end our class, boleh?
InsyaAllah.
Ada question. Alright, so kalau tak ada, thank you for today.
Sekejap, minit saya ada soalan. Untuk yang zero value inside and outside of confidence interval tu, soalan dia memang the sales had improved juga. Adakah yang the sales didn't improve? Tak ada.
Boleh juga. Tapi boleh juga tanya macam tu.
So kalau zero dia outside, maksudnya dia pun boleh not improve lah.
So maksudnya kalau dia kata had improve kan, contohnya kat sini dia kata based on the confidence interval has the sale had not improve kan. Contohnya soalan tu. So maksudnya bila dia kata not improve, maksudnya kita kata apa? Equal lah. Maksudnya tak ada beza pun. Maksudnya kosong tu kena ada dalam confidence interval. Lah. Yes. Betul.
Bukan tu. Kalau increase decrease ada ke?
Increase decrease ada, sama kalau dia kata is the sale had increased, for example. So sama kalau apa nama itu, unequal ke ataupun increase ke decrease ke, kita kata zero tu mesti tak ada dalam confidence interval.
Okay.
Dia kalau ada kita kata equal. Selain daripada tu kita akan tengok kosong yang tak ada lah. Boleh?
Boleh. Thank you.
Okay. Alright, so kalau tak ada apa-apa, thank you for today. Don't forget to fill up your attendance and selamat Hari Raya. Selamat bercuti.
Selamat Hari Raya, Miss Aimina.
Alright. So you all apa beraya di kawasan PKP ke PKPD?
Beraya di rumah.
Beraya di rumah je ada.
Kalau Miss nak beraya online, boleh
lah. Tak apalah. Tak nak saya. Alright, okay. So thank you. Bye.
Thank you, Adam. Selamat Raya.
Thank you, Miss. Selamat Raya.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.